Hello children, welcome for today's biology class. Today we are going to start the next chapter, tissues. The topic going to be covered is differences between plants and animal tissues. Okay, now let us go inside the chapter. So first let us study what is tissue. So tissue is a group of cells having similar structure and function. They should have similar structure and function, then only you call them as tissues. It is a group of cells together having similar structure and function. So there are tissues are there in plants also, animals also. Now let us take one example from animal. For example, in human beings, the muscular tissue, they contract and relax. There are different type of muscle cells, muscular tissue, that is smooth muscle, skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle. Okay, but anyhow, this all together you call them as muscular tissue. So in they, what is the main function of this? They are helpful in contraction and relaxation, and they are helpful in your movements. For example, you are walking from one place to another place, you are doing some work. How do you do? With help of your muscular tissue only. Your heart is working. How is it contracting and relaxing? So by means of cardiac muscle. So like that, this tissue, no, this muscular tissue, they have muscle cells. Okay, so now let us take the other example from plants. So plants, they have, let us take one tissue, there is vascular tissue. So among vascular tissue, no, xylem and phloem are the vascular tissue of plants. So here the xylem, it is helpful in the conduction of water, and phloem is helpful in the conduction of food. Can you see? These all are different type of cells of xylem. Maybe all are looking different, but anyhow altogether they are doing the same function. So you call them as xylem, that is vascular tissue coming under xylem. This is no phloem. So these cells, they are helpful in the conduction of food. So that's why you call them as phloem, which is coming under the heading vascular tissue. Okay, so now let us study the differences between plant tissue and animal tissue. So when you observe the plants, are they able to move from place to place? No, the plants are not able to move from place to place. They are static. So that's why the plants, when you observe, so they are very big and they have to stand and they have to withstand wind. You know, in the case of terrestrial plants, in aquatic plants, they have to withstand the water current. So they need mechanical strength. So how do they get the mechanical strength? By means of these tissues only. And when you observe in plants, most of the cells are dead cells. So you can ask why the dead cells are present. And the dead cells, they provide mechanical support and strength to the plant. Okay, and when you see in the case of plants, the growth only takes place in some regions, and the regions where the growth occurs, no, you call them as meristematic tissue. This is the place where mainly the growing tissues are present, meristematic tissue. Normally when you observe, when the shoot grows, the shoot meristem, it is present in the shoot tip. When the root grows, you can see the root meristem is present in the tip of the root. Okay, so like that. Now let us see regarding animal tissues. So animals, they are able to move from place to place, and they need more energy comparing to plants. So accordingly, most of the this animal cells are present, animal tissues are there. And you know, all animals, we have mostly living cells. Even dead cells are there, you know, hair, nail and all, dead cells. But anyhow, comparing to plants, we have mostly living cells. Okay, so in case of growth of animals, there is more uniform throughout the body. There is no separate meristematic tissue like that, what you can see in plants. So the growth, it occurs throughout the body, uniform all over the body. Okay, so when you observe in the case of animals, we have special organs and they have specialized functions also. So that's why we have more specialized tissues comparing to plants. So animals, highly evolved organisms, so we show more specialized tissue comparing to animals. sorry, comparing to plants. Okay, so in this chapter mainly we are going to study regarding various type of plant tissues and animal tissues. So before going inside the chapter, let us see the differences between plant tissues and animal tissues in a tabular form. What we studied, so here only we are going to discuss in tabular form. In plants, I told you, mainly they consist of dead supportive tissues. In animals, living tissues are common comparing to dead tissues. And plants, they require less energy for maintenance. Animal tissues, they require more energy for maintenance. And plant tissue, you know, meristematic tissues are there. And later, meristematic tissues are converted into permanent tissues. So here, there is no such differentiation in animal tissues. I told you already, the meristematic tissue, that is the place where mainly the growth occurs. But animals, they are not having that type of tissue called meristematic tissue or growth tissue like that. But when you see in the plants, continuously they are growing throughout their life. But in animals, it's not like that. So growth is only up to a particular limit. Okay, and maturity, after maturity, there won't be growth at all. But anyhow, the reparative growth can be there. So in any part, for example, the skin is damaged, if you're having any wound, no, the healing occurs. How does it occur? So by means of reparative growth only. Okay, and plant tissues, no, they show simple organization. Animal tissues, no, they show complex organization. When you observe the tissue organization, in the case of plants, it is mainly meant for stationary habit because the plants, they don't move from one place to another. But in the case of animals, no, it, as the animals, they move from one place to another, so accordingly they show the specialized tissues and all. Okay, children, so you study the differences between the plant tissues and animal tissues. It can be asked in 2 mark questions and 3 mark questions and all. Okay, so today we are concluding up to this. You practice the thing, whatever we studied. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.